which you can get from me if you wish to, or Amazon, Mad HQ. These ones are for MiraFit, M-I-R-A, Fit, and they're sort of normally under £10. And also a stretch band, medium resistance. Okay, let's get started. So just as a warm up to mobilise. Standing nice and tall, so your feet are going to be hip width apart. Hip width is not a light so, as we often see people standing. Hip width apart, so your feet are in line with your hips. And you're going to roll your shoulders around. You're going to bring your hands down by your side. Think about standing tall. So the crown of your head is lengthening up towards the ceiling. Draw the shoulders back, shoulder blades down. So you're sliding your hands down to deep pockets, down by your side. Really tall, lengthening through the crown of the head and really long through your spine. And then bring your elbows around, start to warm up and mobilize the shoulders, opening across the chest, around. Breathing in, breathing out. Deep breaths in, stretch your arms up, breathing out and round. Breathing in, stretching tall, and round. Breathing in and out. Let's bring some feet in as well. So if you can, lift onto your toes, slow, controlled, and round. Breathing in, reaching tall, and round. Breathing in, breathing out. Just one more, and around. And then bring single arm around, around. So a little bit of rotation coming in. So you twist around, you bend your knees slightly, keeping your hips facing forward. The hips aren't twisting around with you, just getting a little bit of rotation around, and round to the hand. Big wide stretch as you circle around. One more to each side. Last one. And then lift both arms up, reaching tall with your hands. Keep your hands together, gently stretch to the side, back to the centre. You're going to keep the weight even between the feet. So you're lifting your ribs up away from your hips, you're not lifting up like so. Trying to lengthen out between the ribs and the side of your hips. You stretch out through to the shoulder from side to side. One arm down, one arm over. I'm down, up and over. Not looking down to the floor, looking straight ahead of you. Stretch and lengthen out for your lats. Weight down into your hips. Cross. And just one more. And then bring your arms out level with the shoulders and circle your arms around, just nice and loose, around. Try not to hunch your shoulders, kind of keep the shoulders down away from your ears still. And then change direction, around, around. Bigger circles, keeping your arms level with the shoulders and bring your feet out wide. So your toes are pointing outwards now, your shoulders are down, and then bend your knees from side to side. Your knees and toes should stay in line. So the toes are pointing outwards. The knees just following the tracking through to your toes. So from side to side, to side. So knees, ankles, feet and hips. Mobilizing. And then to reach across to one ankle and to the center. So the knee that's bending is the leg you're reaching across to. And across to the side. Getting a little bit of a stretch on the inside of your thigh as you reach across to the side, to the center, side, and center. One more to each side. And then last one. Come then, come back to the middle and stretch both arms up. Reaching to the ceiling. Circle your arms around as you bend the knees and then reach down to the floor. Straighten the legs, roll up through your spine. Inhale, stretching tall, arms around, reach down, straighten, roll up and tall, around, reach down, straighten and tall, and one more, around, rolling up, stretching tall, bring your feet back to hip width apart, as you breathe out, bend your knees, release your arms down, nice and loose, breathing in tall again, down, breathing in tall, release down, breathing in and one more, release down, and big stretch, and then circle your arms around, roll your shoulders and hands down. Okay, standing tall still, put your hands hand onto your hips. So we're going to find your neutral spine. Everybody's neutral spine is different. So work out where yours is and get used to finding your neutral spine. So standing tall, you're going to gently rock the hips back and forth. So tilting the pelvis by tucking the tailbone under. So forward and back. So you're arching the back and then flattening out. Tipping back, tipping forward, back and forward. Staying tall and then slowly lessening the movement little by little, allowing your hips. Imagine a rocking chair that's losing momentum and just settling in to the point where you feel most balanced and natural, and hold it there. So you're finding neutral spine, then you're engaging your core. You're gonna pull your belly button in towards your spine. So if you're doing a pair of jeans that are really tight, and then doing a zip up, zipping all the way to the top as far as you can, with your pelvic floor muscles drawing all the way up. So really strong. And then release out and down by just over halfway and hold. So it should just feel nice and snug and maintain neutral spine. So your core is now engaged, your spine is in neutral, hold it there. A little bit of balance work, you're gonna lift one foot off the floor, standing on one leg. If you're on a mat, it's a little bit harder than if you're standing on a hard floor. And then straighten that leg out and bend it back in, straightening out. And then if you need to start off, if your balance isn't very good, then you can always hold onto something by your side or holding onto the wall. And then circle the foot around. So I'm on two mats here, which is a little bit spongier than if I was on the hard floor. Around the other way. Just getting the ankle loosened off. And then bring that foot down again. Changing legs, lift the leg up, standing tall, nicely balanced, straighten the leg, and bend. Straighten out and bend, straighten and bend. And then keep the knee bent and circle the foot around, 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 around the other way, around, around. And then bring the foot down again. And then with your shoulders back again, round with your hands down by your side. And now you're going to look over one shoulder. And then to the other shoulder. So as if you're viewing the horizon from shoulder to shoulder, shoulder to shoulder. And then chin down and across, down and across, and across, down and across. And then looking down to the floor and look up to the ceiling. Looking up, tuck your chin down, roll your shoulders forward, slide your hands down, let your arms hang down loose. Your knees are soft, you haven't got the legs completely straight, just take the tension out from behind your knees. And then slowly roll back up again, lift shoulders back, and down. We're going to come down to the floor. Standing at the back of the mat. You can tuck your chin down, roll your shoulders forward, slide your hands down, soften the knees, let your arms hang down, and then walk your hands forward. And then coming onto hands and knees. So from all fours, tuck your chin down, lengthen your spine up towards the ceiling, and then scooping out, arch the back. Any of these are good to do first thing in the morning, just to loosen off, or before any exercise activities. Not getting the heart rate up, you're just mobilising joints. Scooping out, arch the back. And probably this side of Christmas, it probably needs a little bit of persuasion to move if you've been on the sofa too long. Tuck the chin down and lengthen. And this time tuck the chin down, flatten out your feet and sit your hips back to your heels. Stretch your arms forward to child pose. Come up to hands and knees, put the back of one hand on the floor, slide the hand through as you bring your shoulder down to the floor. If you can also here, stretch the back of the shoulder. To the centre, to the other side, slide the hand through, stretch the back of the shoulder. And back again, and back to child pose, stretch your arms forward. lift your hips up, cross your ankles over. Sit with your legs crossed if you're comfortable doing so. You can pop a cushion underneath your hips to help you sit taller, or with your legs in front of you, your shoulders are down, gonna slide one hand away. Keep your sit bones firm onto the floor. So stretch from shoulder down to your hip, hold the stretch, looking up the ceiling. To the centre, to the other side, stretch up and over, hold the stretch. Back to the centre, and then looking round over one shoulder, the hands on the knee, shoulders down, tall through the crown of the head. To the centre, to the other side, round behind you. Back to the centre, bring your feet in front of you, just come down onto your back and bring your knees into your chest, rocking your knees. So just feel the lower back through to your tailbone being massaged into the floor. Your hands under your knees or thighs, tap your toes down and hug the knees in, tapping down, hug the knees in, tapping down, hug the knees in, down and hugging in, down and hugging in. And then bring your feet to the floor, bring your arms out wide, still getting with your shoulders relaxed into the floor, so no hunching of your shoulders. Your feet and knees are going to stay together as you breathe in, bring the knees over to your left side. Your right foot will lift off the floor. Breathing out and come back to the centre, to the other side. This nice spine twist, knees across to the side. Exhale, back to the centre. So from each side across, stretching out, rotating gently from side to side. Side to side. Last one, and then come back to the centre, straighten out one leg, opposite hand to your knee, the foot is on top of the knee, bring the hand onto the knee, bring the knee across the side and look away from the knee. Should be a nice little stretch to your lower back, through to your glutes, almost really from your knee through your hips, lower back and the opposite shoulder. And to the centre, changing legs, bring the knee across and look away from the knee, stretch the hip and glute. And then come back to the centre, hug both knees in towards you, lifting a tailbone off the floor, and again rock your knees back and forth, and then pop the feet to the floor, bring your feet and knees to the hip width apart, and your arms down by your side, sliding your fingertips down towards your heels, your neck stays long. And then take a deep breath in, on the out breath, push your lower back into the floor, curl the tailbone up, and release. Exhale as you tilt, belly band to spine, zip up through pelvic floor, inhale, release. Exhale, tilting, inhale. Exhale, tilt. Try when you can to exhale, breathing out through pursed lips and then breathe in through your nose. Helps engage the core and control the breathing. Inhale, release. Nice, long, deep breaths. Breathing out. Inhale, release. Exhale, tilt. Inhale, release. Just one more. And release. And roll over onto your side. Over to hands and knees. Into a cat stretch, you tuck your chin down, lengthen your spine, scoop out and arch your back, looking upwards, again, head down, lengthen and lower your hips down to your heels, stretch your arms, we'll bring your knees slightly apart if it helps your hips go a little bit lower, reach the fingertips forward, you keep your tailbone tucked under. That's warm up and mobilising done. If you add it on to the beginning of each day or just throw it in wherever you want to before or after exercise. See you tomorrow.